Being here to witness a union between two special people. We are all currently living in an interesting time of human existence. Therefore, it is a testament to the love you all have for Lisa and Raphael that you made it here today without promise of air conditioning and refreshments.
I met Lisa
at work. Co-workers soon became friends, a shoulder to lean on, and vice versa. I don't know Raphael personally. I feel in some way I do, considering conversations with Lisa, where she shared many details of his love for her and his children. I take pride in having this opportunity to be the ordained minister for this joyous occasion. Not just to keep Lisa and Raphael from a detention center ceremony, no matter how epic that may have been, but to help make this a special occasion with personalized sentiment. Before we begin, I would like to give each of you. I am so happy for the two of you right now on this special day. Not being there for the ceremony is painful for me, Debbie, and your mom, but we take comfort in knowing you understand, and we are grateful that you accept what is going on around us now. As you said, there's no reason to risk a lifetime of happiness for an hour of getting together. That said, a big part of me said to roll the dice and go anyway so I could give you a big hug. I've watched you grow into the amazing child that entertained us all to an amazingly smart, independent woman with the biggest heart a person can have, and so I'm glad that Raphael recognized what we all knew. There is a Subaru car commercial most people have seen, where the dad gets his daughter the keys to the new car, and she starts to drive off. He sees her as a young child and seems to think, wait, you can't drive yet. It's like that with you and your brothers, and I can tell you it's a very good thing. So even though you're an adult now, I can still picture the horses and the pony I promised but never bought. And about how...
Remembered.
And about how... Every morning at work telling me you didn't want to go to school and later work. Others may not believe it was every morning, but it's true.
It was every morning.
And I still have the picture you drew of yourself saying, on board, that I kept on my desk forever. Funny drawings and pictures from Lisa have entertained us for years. Helping you in any way I can will always be something I enjoy more than just about anything. Now I know I get carried away worrying, like the time you called me from work at Intelecom, about, I think someone was checking out your car, and I was convinced that terrorists were stalking you, that you needed to come right home. In fairness, there were a lot of terrorists in the news at that time.
Someone's in my car was messy, and she assumed that meant somebody was breaking into my car.
Brave as you are, of course, you have your fears, as we all know, and a call to home to kill a spider in your room or apartment is nothing out of the ordinary. I think we all have a copy of the note you hung at the house with the picture about the spider of doom. In fairness, as well, you were the one that had to walk the driveway early every morning after a night of bed moving.
I had a stick.
I'm proud that together we have solved some pretty big problems over the years, and appreciate that you trusted me that way. So they say a dad is supposed to give his daughter away, which is something left over from when daughters were property, and that's definitely not the case here. But there is another part which is true, in that you and Raph can now be partners, companions, and problem solvers in this next chapter of your life. It's challenging and hard work, but the rewards are special and will last forever. I'm thrilled that you have found someone that you now trust with every part of your being and who will do whatever it takes to make you happy. Don't think for a minute that I resent that or think that I'll ever be a part of helping you. Not be a part of helping you. Because any parent will tell you that knowing your kids are being taken meltdown and want to call me as I carry three suitcases to the airport, I'll take comfort that someone else has got this. I know you'll always be someone who makes smart decisions, solves problems, and does everything to make my home a right here. The fact that this day happened at all, with so many reasons why it shouldn't have, is a perfect example of that. If it's one thing we've learned these past months, it's carpe diem, seize the day. So even though we're all trying to recover from the whiplash of this, we all know that when you know, and that life is short. Seeing the two of you fall in love has made us all very happy. Congratulations, Mom and Dad.
Aw, thanks, Dad. If you can see me.
All right, let us hear Rory, Penelope, and Olive. Promising to help guide them through life during good times and bad, a promise to love and support them as part of Raphael. And as individuals. Raphael, a commitment not only to Lisa, but also to hashtag Team Marilyn, Charlie, and Prudence. Promising to help guide them through life during good times and bad, a promise to love and support them as part of Lisa and as individuals. Let this ceremony be a statement of what you mean to each other and the commitment of family you officially make here today. Redwoods can live for thousands of years. They are the largest living thing on Earth, that descended from lime trees that existed 110 million years ago. May the words spoken here today and the choice of Lisa and Raphael to enter into this marriage be a union as everlasting as those ancient trees. May your marriage provide love and support for each other to expand to your highest purpose, and may the joining of your lives provide a sanctuary where you both feel secure to explore your individualities, who you are together. We thank you for the love that has grown between these two people, for their commitment to one another. Bless their marriage and fill their union with grace and joy. May they grow together in the image of your nature. Give them the grace to forgive and receive forgiveness, a love that overflows to others around them, and a home that is a haven of blessing and peace. Make this relationship a living and constant proof of your power to transform lives and the possibilities that come with love seeking the other's good. Thank you for this mystery of beautiful unity that shows us something about your love and commitment to us. Lisa and Raphael, you have declared before all of us that you will live together in marriage. You have made special promises to each other. You have symbolized your sacred bond by joining hands, taking vows, and exchanging rings. May you strive to meet this commitment with the same love and devotion that you feel today. Now that you've joined yourself in matrimony by the authority vested in me by the Universal Life Church, I now pronounce you our husband and wife. You may seal this marriage with a kiss. Woo! I am delighted to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Lugo.
Woo-hoo!
Good enough.
My love, Lisa. implications of homelessness, eternity, timelessness. It implies an idea of movement and symbolizes the cycle of time and the planet turning around the sun. The circle is also zero in our numbering system, symbolizing potential. It has magical value as a protective seal. These mirrors are the seal of vows of purity and represent the promise of everlasting love. They are an outward, visible symbol of inward loving honor. These rings symbolize the unbroken circle of love. Lisa, as you place the ring on Raphael's hand.